Good morning po sa ating lahat. Welcome po sa online service ng Chcc. So before we start our praise and worship po, may you join me in a short prayer. Lord, we thank you for this wonderful day ng Panginoon. Lord, maraming salamat po, Lord, sa kapayapaan na binigay niyo sa amin to praise and worship your goodness, your holy name, Heavenly Father. Lord, these songs, Panginoon, ito po yung naalay namin sa inyo at tanging sa inyo, Panginoon. Maraming salamat po sa araw na ito. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
All the saints and angels, they bow before your throne. All the angels cast crowns before the Lamb of God and sing, "You worthy of it all. For from you are all things, and to you are all things, you deserve glory." Singing, "Oh,
not in day, not in sense. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory. You are worthy of it all. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory. Day and night, night and day, and it's in surprise. Day and night, night and day, and it's in surprise. Day and night, night and day, you are worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all, yes, oh God. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory. For from you are all things, to you are all things. You deserve the glory.
Good umaga po mga kapatid. October 25 na naman, so Sunday, kaya kinakailangan tayo'y maghanda sa pagpupuri sa ating Panginoon. So sa kalam po ng Church on the Hill Christian Community, akin po kayong wini-welcome dito sa ating online Sunday celebration. At patuloy po tayong dumulog sa trono ng ating Panginoon at tayong lahat ay manalangin. Aming Ama na nasa langit, sa pangalan ng inyong anak na si Jesus, sa kapangyarihan ng inyong Espiritu Santo, nagpupuri kami sa inyo, Panginoon, sa araw na ito. Dinadakila namin ang inyong banal na pangalan at hinihiling namin, Panginoon, maghari ka sa buhay ng bawat isa. Kumilos po kayo sa buhay ng bawat isa na nakikinig sa broadcast na ito. Dalangin namin, Lord, na ikaw ang patuloy na maghari, ikaw ang patuloy na kumilos, ikaw ang patuloy na gumawa sa kanilang mga buhay upang maranasan nila ang iyong presensya sa kanilang mga buhay. Kaya nga, Panginoon, dinadalangin ko ang iyong pagpapala, ang iyong pangunguna, ang iyong paggabay sa amin. Lalong-lalo na sa araw na ito, na kung saan ito'y araw na itinalaga namin to glorify your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So, umagang ito, kung mapapansin po ninyo, ngayon ay halos po 8 buwan na na tayo ay merong crisis dito sa Pilipinas. At sabi nga nung iba, matira matibay. So yung tinatawag na survival. Ano po, alam niyo mga kapatid, sa tingin ko hindi kinakailangan na mag-survive lamang tayo. Ang kalooban ng Panginoon sa buhay ng bawat isa sa atin, tayong lahat ay magtagumpay. Kaya nga yung tema natin na overcomer, I think, yun yung plano at kalooban ng Diyos sa buhay ng bawat isa sa atin, na tayong lahat ay maging mananagumpay or isang overcomer. At sabi ko nga sa inyo, survival, sabi nila, is a state of continuing to live or exist in spite of difficult conditions. It is also means holding on to a critical position while under attack. So lahat tayo ngayon ay under attack. Nakikita natin how this pandemic affects our whole being, our way of life, our economy, our spiritual life. Pero, sabi ko nga sa inyo, hindi tayo kinakailangan magpatalo dito sa pandemic na ito. Kinakailangan makita natin kung paano tayo magiging overcomer o magiging mananagumpay sa crisis na ating dinadaanan. Tunay na nare-realize natin, mga kapatid, Christian life is a battle. Tayo ay nasa isang pakikipagdigmaan, and this battle is real and intense. Makikita natin how although walang bomba pa na sumasabog, pero makikita natin yung tremendous effect sa buhay ng bawat isa sa atin. So whether you believe it or not, hindi magbabago yung katotohanan na tayo pong lahat ay nasa isang pakikipagdigmaan. We are at war. Okay? We are at war. At bilang mga anak ng Diyos, kinakailangan, alam natin, hindi lang how to survive, kundi how to triumph or how to become an overcomer sa panahong ito. You know, ever since, ano, from the very beginning, there's a conflict between good and evil, between God and Satan. So, continuing itong battle na ito. And gaya ng ating pinag-uusapan ngayong month ng October, yung temptation ni Jesus. And I believe tayong lahat ay kinakailangang maging overcomer katulad ng ating Panginoon. Nais kong basahin natin yung Book of Ephesians chapter 6, okay, verse 12. At ang sabi nga dito, "For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the powers, against the world forces of this darkness, against the spiritual forces of wickedness in the heavenly places." So, we are at war. Okay? That's the reality. And we need to be vigilant. We need to be ready sa pakikipagdigmaang ito. At sa umagang ito, magbibigay ako ng ilang mga principles on how to win our war in the world. So, the title of my sermon is Winning Our War in the World. We are at war. At ang kalooban ng Panginoon, bawat isa sa atin ay magtagumpay. So kung matututuhan lamang natin yung mga ilang principles mula sa banal na kasulatan, kung paano natin mapagtatagumpayan yung ating pakikipagdigmaan, I believe with all my heart, ma-overcome natin itong crisis na ito na dumadaan sa ating mga buhay. So, magbibigay po ako ng ilang mga principles in order for us to win our war in this world. Number one principle, know your enemy. Okay? Know your enemy. Katulad sa pandemic na ito, mga kapatid, we have an unseen enemy. Yung virus, hindi nga natin nakikita. Kalaban natin to. Pero alam nyo po ba, bago pa nagkaroon ng pandemic, meron ng tinuturo ang banal na kasulatan dun sa ating unseen enemy. So, sabi ko nga sa inyo dito sa Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12, makikita natin, sabi dito, "We are not fighting against flesh and blood." So, hindi tao ang ating kalaban. Sabi dito, "But against the rulers, against the powers, against the world forces of this darkness, and against spiritual forces of wickedness in the heavenly places." So, I think Paul is talking about who is our real enemy. Paul is talking about rulers, powers, world forces of this darkness, and spiritual forces of wickedness. So, the enemy is real. Okay? We have an enemy. At ito, pinangalanan nga ni Paul. And I believe, hindi lang ito diniferentiate ni Paul yung mga kalaban natin, kung hindi inispecify niya kung anong klase yung ating kalaban. Unseen forces of wickedness. Yun ang sabi dito, no? So, we need to know who is our real enemy. So, hindi ka po pwedeng, hindi mo pwedeng deadmahin na meron tayong kalaban, mga kapatid. Kaya nga sa umagang ito, the first principle na I want you to know your enemy. Okay? Ang kalaban natin ay hindi yung gobyerno. Ang kalaban natin ay hindi yung kapwa natin Pilipino. Ang kalaban natin ay hindi yung ating mga mahal sa buhay. Kumisan ay nagkakagulo na sa loob ng pamilya. Meron tayong real enemy na dapat nating kaharapin. At ang sabi nga rito, rulers, powers, world forces of wicked, world forces in this darkness, and spiritual forces or unseen forces of wickedness in the heavenly realm. Pangalawa pong principle, mga kapatid, kung ito yung ating mga kalaban, the second principle is know your arena. Okay? So una, know your adversary or enemy. Pangalawa, know your arena. Okay? Arena is the sphere or area of conflict. Ang tawag natin dito, the battleground. Okay? The battleground. It is the sphere or area of conflict or the sphere or area of struggle or of battle. Kaya nga, battleground, no? It is a must for us to be familiarized with the location of the battlefield because it is where the battle occurs. So, importante sa isang sundalo yung kabisaduhin mo yung location kung saan magaganap yung digmaan. Kasi kung hindi mo alam yung location, magiging disadvantage yun on our part. Similarly, sa context natin sa ating Christian life, mga kapatid, know your adversary or your enemy, know your arena. The arena of the battle or the battleground kung wherein kung saan magaganap yung mga digmaan. So, the battle arena is first and foremost in the spiritual realm or spiritual dimension. Okay? Because, sabi ko nga sa inyo kanina, we have an invisible enemy. We have an invisible adversary or foe in the spiritual dimension. Kaya nga, binanggit ni Paul, balikan ko lang yung ating text, ano? But against the rulers, against the powers, against the world forces of this darkness, against the spiritual forces of wickedness in the heavenly places. So yung in the heavenly places, he talks about in the spiritual realm. Okay? Kaya nga, sabi sa Ephesians chapter 2, verse 2, no? Tinawag niya yung ating kalaban na the prince of the power of the air. Bakit tinawag na the prince of the power of the air? Kasi nga, si Satan, our real enemy, meron siyang cohorts, yung mga rulers, yung mga powers, yung mga spiritual forces, yung kanyang domain. So, importante mga kapatid, alam natin kung saan yung pakikipagdigmaan at ang sabi nga ni Apostol Pablo, in the heavenly places or in the spiritual realm or spiritual dimensions. Kaya nga, in the last days, Satan will intensify his effort to make a havoc against Christians. For example, itong internet, okay, or yung media, ay po pwedeng gamitin ng kalaban against the humanity. Very powerful. He who controls the media controls the world. Kaya nga, importante rito, mga kapatid, yung digmaan na ito na kung saan ay we need to be aware that this battle, first and foremost, occur or happens in the spiritual realm. So his forces are very highly organized, structured, and powerful. Kaya kung hindi po natin nare-realize kung saan yung battleground or yung arena, abay, mag-ingat po tayo. So, the spiritual battle happens in the spiritual realm. Okay? Do not underestimate what the devil can do. Okay? For the battle For it is a battle in a grand scale. Nowadays, alam nyo, ibubuhos na ng ating kalaban yung lahat ng kanyang arsenals, lahat ng kanyang kakayahan upang maghasik ng chaos dito sa salibutan ito. At we need to be aware na ang pakikipagdigmaan natin bilang mga mananampalataya in the spiritual realm ay hindi po magiging madali. I tell you, mga kapatid, in the last days, sabi nga, difficult times will come. Mas matindi yung magiging pakikipagdigmaan ng ating kakaharapin, lalong-lalo na hindi lamang sa panahon natin ngayon, kundi sa susunod na mga henerasyon, yung spiritual conflict, spiritual battle that will took place first and foremost in the arena of the spiritual realm. Okay? Because whatever happens in the physical realm has its roots in the spiritual realm. Okay? So, una-una, in the spiritual realm or in the spiritual dimension, in the heavenly places, yun ang sabi ni Apostol Pablo, yung doon maaring maganap yung pakikipagdigmaan. At yun po ay ongoing. Yun po ay relentless. Even from the beginning of time na kung saan nagkaroon ng conflict between good and evil, between Satan and God, yung pakikipagdigmaan na yun ay nagpapatuloy hanggang ngayon. At sabi ko sa inyo, whatever happens in the physical realm has its roots in the spiritual realm or in the heavenly places. So the second battle arena is in the physical realm. Okay? So yun yung second battle arena or battleground in the physical. Okay? Kaya nga si Apostle Pablo, particularly sa Book of Ephesians, he talks about different arena in the spiritual realm. Kasi merong manifestation yung conflict na ito dito sa physical world. Okay? Una-una, mga kapatid, yung in the ethnic community. Kaya nga si Paul, sa chapter 2, binanggit niya yung ethnic discrepancy between the Jews and the Gentiles. So malaking usapin po yan, yung ethnic differences ng Jews and Gentiles. But thanks be to God, sa pamamagitan ng ating Panginoon Jesucristo, ni-reconcile niya. There's neither Jew or Greeks or Gentiles. There's no male and female. So binrig ni Lord yung mga dividing wall na yan. At yan ang isa sa ginawa ng ating Panginoon na bunga ng kanyang redemption para mawala yung dividing wall between the Jews and the Gentiles. At hindi lang po yung Jews and Gentiles or yung tinatag na ethnic differences, but yung mga differences sa loob ng church. Kung papansinin natin, ito yung pinakabuod nung paksa na binabanggit ni Apostle Pablo, na kung saan he talks about the unity in the body of Christ, in the church. So, mula sa chapter 4 hanggang chapter 5, 21, makikita natin, he talks about the unity in the church, the gifting, the doctrines, and the relationship inside the body of Christ. So, yun yung context dun sa chapter 4 hanggang chapter 5 ng Book of Ephesians. Kasi, yun nga po, whatever happens in the physical realm has its roots in the heavenly realm. So, merong digmaan sa heavenly realm, meron ding digmaan o conflict na nangyari in the physical realm. Not only that, in the family. So, Paul talks about different kinds of relationship inside the family. So, nauna na yung in the ethnic community, in the church, and in the family. So, makikita natin sa chapter 5, verse 22, hanggang chapter 6, verse 4, makikita natin doon yung different kind of relationship inside the family or yung tinatag na domestic relationship. So, una-una, Paul talks about the relationship between husband and wife. Kasi may conflict dun eh. Pag hindi natin nakikita na nagiging battleground yung tahanan, we miss the point. We will lose the battle kasi nga merong pakikipagdigmaan in the physical realm, particularly even inside the family. Merong conflict. Kaya nga nagkakaroon ng clash yung husband and wife, nagkakaroon ng clash yung mga children to their parents and parents to their children and even to the family members. Nagkakaroon ng conflict, nagkakaroon ng chaos, nagkakaroon ng iba't ibang misunderstanding kasi nga there is a battle going on even inside the family. And not only that, even in the workplace. Binanggit ni Paul yung conflict even in the workplace. Kaya he talks about the relationship between the employer and the employees. Kaya nga, even in the workplace, merong manifestation yung conflict. So that is the arena. Andun yung digmaan. So in the spiritual realm, yes. And even in the physical realm, yes, there's a battle that is going on. Even in the ethnic community, in the church, in the family, and even in the workplace. So we need to be aware dun sa digmaan na ito na nangyayari, mga kapatid. That there's a battle going on in this sphere of influence, okay? Pangatlo, mga kapatid, yung battle arena is in the inner person, okay? Sa pagkatao, sa loob, sa kaloob-looban ng isang tao, there's an inner conflict from within na we need to be aware of. So, hindi lang in the spiritual realm, hindi lang in the physical realm, subalit in the inner person, in each and every one of us, there is a constant struggle. You know what? Ito yung ating old nature and new nature. Ito yung ating carnal nature at ito yung ating spiritual nature. Kaya nga, there is an ongoing conflict within us na we need to be aware of. Kaya nga, sabi ni Paul sa Ephesians 3, verse 4, 14, and 16, sabi niya, "For this reason, I bow my knees before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth derive its name, that He would grant you, according to the riches of His glory, to be strengthened with power through His Spirit in the inner man." So bakit kinakailangan even yung ating inner man ay ma-strengthen ng kanyang espiritu? Because there is a ongoing conflict from within. Kaya nga, ito yung mga arena na kinakailangan nating babantayan. So we need to wrestle in the spiritual realm, we need to wrestle in the physical realm, and we need to wrestle from within. And that's the reality of our conflict, brothers and sisters. Ito yung tatlong dimension ng ating pakikipagdigmaan. Kaya akala natin, itong digma na ito ay parang simple lang. Hindi po ito ganito kasimple. Kundi makikita natin, it is a constant struggle na patuloy nating nararanasan araw-araw in our lives. Kaya nga, know your arena. So una, know your adversary. Pangalawa, know your arena. So, advantage na sa atin kung kilala mo na kalaban mo at kilala mo kung saan yung battleground or arena. Pangatlo, mga kapatid, in order for us to win our war in the world, we must know your armors. Dapat alam mo yung sandata mo. And you know how to use it properly. So, posibleng may sandata ka, pero hindi mo alam kung paano mo gagamitin. Or maybe hindi mo aware na meron ka palang sandata na kinakailangan mong gamitin. Kaya dito sa Banal na Kasulatan, maliwanag po yung sinasabi ni Apostol Pablo sa Ephesians chapter 6. Sabi niya, "Therefore," verse 13, "Therefore, put on every piece of God's armor." Hallelujah. Merong God's armor na po pwede tayong gamitin. So you will be able to stand or resist the enemy in the time of evil. So, God has provided an armor or armors na maaari nating gamitin so that we will be able to resist the enemy in time of evil. That after the battle, you will still be standing firm. So makikita natin, as we use the armors that God provides, then we will be able to stand firm in the evil time. Kaya nga, I think it will be a disadvantage for a believer na una-una, hindi siya aware dun sa kanyang weapons. So bilang isang sundalo, you need to be aware dun sa kanyang weapon, no? Dun nga dun sa movie na naman title nun, talagang sabi niya, my weapon is my life, sabi niya. So merong isang movie, isang war movie na training pa lang, yun ang kanilang naging orientation. Sabi niya, my weapon is my life. Kasi nakasalalay ang buhay ng isang sundalo dun sa kanyang weapon. Kaya nga, una-una, he needs to be familiarized with his weapon and he should know how to use it. Kasi kung hindi mo alam kung paano mo gagamitin yung mga weapon na yun, sayang, mga kapatid. Kaya nga, sabi rito, stand your ground, putting on the belt of truth and the body armor of God's righteousness. For shoes, put on the peace that comes from the good news so that you will be fully prepared. In addition, in all this, hold up to the shield of faith to stop the fiery arrows of the devil. Put on the salvation as your helmet and take the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, and pray in the Spirit at all times and on every occasion. Stay alert, be persistent in your prayers for all believers everywhere. So, thank God. Binigyan niya tayo ng mga sandata upang gamitin natin, upang labanan natin ang anumang atake ng atake ng ating kalaban sa ating mga buhay. So, there's no reason for us na hindi tayo magtatagumpay. Kaya nga sabi rito, put on the full armor of God. We need to be fully equipped with God's armor. At kapag tayo po ay fully equipped, magiging unstoppable po tayo. At makikita natin kung paano tayo magtatagumpay sa ating mga pakikipagdigmaan. So, unang principle, know your adversary, know your arena, and know your armors, and finally, know your allies. Okay. Sa isang pakikipagdigmaan, kinakailangan kilala mo kung sinong kakampi mo o sinong kasama mo sa pakikipagdigmaan. You know, hindi natin kayang makipagdigmaan kung tayo po ay nagsosolo. Yung tinatawag na parang katulad nung movie ni Sylvester Stallone na Rambo. Alam nyo, sa movie lang po yun totoo. Pero in the real life, hindi ka magtatagumpay if you are alone. You cannot win this battle alone. So you need to know your allies. Okay. Katulad nung panahon ng World War II, no? Yung tinatawag na Allied Forces. Kung paano nila tinalo yung Germany at yung Japan during the Second World War. Abay, nagsama-sama po yung mga bansa upang magtulong-tulong upang harapin itong pakikipagdigmaan nila against the Nazi regime and the Imperial Army of Japan. So, kailangan natin ng collaboration, kailangan natin ng partnership, kailangan natin ng kasama sa pakikipagdigma na ito. Kaya nga, know your allies. Okay. Sabi sa chapter 6, verse 10, sabi dito, be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. In fact, this battle is not ours. The battle is the Lord. Tayo po, mga kapatid, ay mga sundalo lamang ng ating Panginoon. But first and foremost, we need to know that this is the Lord's battle. At tayo po ay mga kasangkapan ng Diyos or mga armies of the Lord. Sundalo ng Panginoon. Pero ito po ay pakikipagdigmaan ng Diyos. So, we need to be in partnership with our Commander-in-Chief, our Lord Jesus Christ. But thanks be to God. He has won this battle. So, yung ating pakikipagdigmaan ngayon, mga kapatid. Okay. Sabi nga, we are not fighting for victory. We are fighting from victory. Because Jesus has won the battle. Kaya siya nagpunta rito sa salibutang ito to redeem us from death, to conquer the enemy. Kaya nga he dethroned the enemy, he disarmed the enemy, he destroyed the enemy actually. So yung mga kalaban natin ngayon parang mga nagiging remnants na lamang, mga kung naalala nyo during the Second World War, isang illustration dito eh, nag-surrender na yung Japan to the Allied Forces. Okay. Pero, marami pa rin mga Japanese soldiers na nagtatago sa ibang mga lugar, iba't ibang mga kabundukan. At hindi pa rin nila isinusurrender yung kanilang mga sarili. So, ganun din po mga kapatid, no? Nagtagumpay na ang ating Panginoon eh. Kaya lang, meron pa rin siyang, yung kalaban natin, meron pa rin mga remnants o mga sundalo o kalaban na still operational until now na pilit pa rin nilang tinatangka na talunin. Hindi na nila kayang talunin ng Panginoon. Kaya nga tinatalo na niya at pilit niyang tinutukso at dinadaya at pilit na sinisira ay yung mga mananampalataya. Yung mga mananampalataya sa iba't ibang denomination, mga mananampalataya sa iba't ibang mga churches, yung mga mananampalataya sa iba't ibang pamilya, yung mga mananampalataya even in the workplace. Handun yung spiritual conflict. Kaya nga, we need to be aware that we are not fighting for victory, but we are fighting from victory. Okay? So, we must be alert because we are in a constant battle. But thanks be to God, nanalo na po ang ating Panginoong Jesucristo. Nagtagumpay na po siya. Na-overcome na niya ang sanlibutan ito. Na-overcome na rin niya ang si Satan at ang devil. Talunan na po sila, mga kapatid. And that's the reality na kinakaharap ng bawat isa sa atin. So, know your allies, no? And we are not only sons and daughters and servants of God. First and foremost, we need to realize that we are soldiers of God. Tayo po yung mga sundalo ng Diyos. Tayo po yung mga lingkod ng ating Panginoon. Kaya nga, our Bible tells us that we are more than conquerors. Okay? Overcomers. And victorious in Christ. Yun ang sabi ng Bible natin. At nagpapatunay po na talagang nagtagumpay na ang ating Panginoon. Kaya nga, ang kalooban ng Diyos sa buhay ng bawat isa sa atin, isustain natin yung victory na yon ng ating Panginoon. Na tayo maging overcomer, maging victorious, maging more than conquerors. Yun ang sabi ng Banal na Kasulatan, we are more than conquerors. At di ba pinapangako ng Panginoon sa buhay ng bawat isa sa atin, mga kapatid? Sabi niya, I will build my church. So we are His church. We are His ecclesia. At ang pangako ng Diyos, di ba? Sabi niya, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. So ano man yung kapangyarihan ng kadiliman, ano man yung kapangyarihan ni Satanas, ano man yung kanyang pagtatangka to destroy the church, to destroy His ecclesia, it will not succeed. Why? Because we are in a winning side because of what Christ has done for us. Ano na lang po yung dapat nating gawin, mga kapatid? Sabi po sa James chapter 4, verse 7, submit to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. First and foremost, we need to submit to God. Ang tawag ko dito, remain. Remain in God. Yung ating constant abiding, yung ating constant submission to God. So we need to be under submission to God before resisting the enemy. So kinakailangan magpasakop ka muna sa Diyos. Kilalanin mo muna yung paghahari ng Diyos sa iyong buhay. Kilalanin mo na si Jesus ang iyong commander-in-chief. Kilalanin mo na siya ang iyong boss. Kilalanin mo si Kristo sa iyong mga buhay. Kaya nga, submit to God. Submit to His Lordship. Submit to His Kingship. Submit to His authority and power. And I tell you, brothers and sisters, as we submit to God, we are able to resist the enemy. How to resist the enemy? So, hindi yung parang ini-entertain mo yung kalaban mo. Hindi. Pag sinabing resist, we are on an aggressive mode or in a fighting mode against the enemy. Kaya nga, mga kapatid, this morning, I'm challenging every Christian, every believer to resist the enemy by the power of God, by the power of the Holy Spirit, by the power of His Word. Kaya nga, kung mapapansin nyo ang ating Panginoon, no? He resists the enemy by using the Word of God. Yung pinag-aralan natin sa Matthew chapter 4. But hindi siya nagpa-intimidate. Hindi niya in-accommodate. Kung hindi, he resists the enemy by using the power of God, the Word of God, the sword of the Spirit. Kaya nga, sabi ng banal na kasulatan, submit to God. Okay. Resist the devil. Ano mangyayari? Sabi dito, he will flee from you. Same thing sa ating Panginoon Jesu Kristo. Resist niya yung kalaban. Ano nangyari? The enemy left him defeated. So umagang ito, mga kapatid, kalooban ng Diyos na tayo hindi lang mag-survive kung hindi magtagumpay. To be an overcomer. We are more than conquerors. We are victorious because of what Christ has done for all of us. Kaya nga ang aking challenge, mga kapatid, huwag kayong magpa-intimidate sa ating unseen enemy. Sa halip, kilalanin natin kung sino ang tunay nating kalaban. Alamin natin kung saan yung ating battleground, the arena of our conflict. Sabi ko sa inyo, it is in the heavenly realms. Yes, it is also in the physical realm. But there's also a conflict in the inner man or in the inner person. Kaya nga, we need to be aware of the arena kung saan nagkakaroon ng conflict. But thanks be to God. Yes, we have an enemy. And aware na tayo dun sa location or arena ng ating conflict. Pero magpasalamat tayo sa Diyos. God has given us all equipment, all armory necessary for us to stand still, to stand firm in this battle, in this evil time. Kaya nga, we are so confident, mga kapatid, na tayo yung magtatagumpay. Lalong-lalo na, aware tayo kung sino ang ating kakampi. Kakampi natin ang Diyos, mga kapatid. If God is for us, who can be against us? Okay? If God is on our side, kasama natin ang Diyos. Sabi ng Panginoon, I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. I'm with you even to the end of the age. Brothers and sisters, just hold on. Okay? Continue to submit to God. Continue to resist the enemy. At hindi siya tatagal. He will flee from us. Kaya nga, this morning, I'm challenging every believer. We can win our war in the world. As we know, your enemy, your arena, your armors, and your allies, by the grace of God. Dalangin ko sa Panginoon, itong simpleng sermon na ito, simpleng pag-aaral ng salita ng Diyos na ito, ay makatulong sa bawat isa sa atin upang tayong lahat ay magtagumpay sa ating pakikipagdigman. Kaya, let's apply what we have learned. Sabi ng banal na kasulatan, isa sa weapon na ibinigay ng Panginoon sa atin ay yung pananalangin. Pray in the Spirit. Pray in the Spirit at all times and on every occasion. Stay alert and be persistent in your prayers for all the believers everywhere. I am inviting everyone to hold your ground, to pray at all times, and pray in the Spirit as we fight this battle together. Manalangin po tayo. Aming Ama na nasa langit, sa pangalan ng inyong anak na si Jesus, sa kapangyarihan ng inyong Espiritu Santo, kami po ay nagpapasalamat dahil nakilala ka namin. Dahil ikaw ang Diyos na nananahan sa puso at buhay ng bawat isa sa amin. Mula nung isinuko namin ang aming buhay sa iyo, Panginoon, we belong to you, O God. At dahil po dito, Panginoon, we came to realize kung gaano ka kadakila, kung gaano ka kabuti, kung gaano kaganda ang mga plano mo sa buhay ng bawat isa sa amin. Yes, Lord. Kami po ay hinango mo sa karumihan. Hinango mo kami sa kaharian ng kadiliman. At dinala mo kami sa kaharian ng iyong bugtong na anak na si Jesus. Upang kami ay hindi lamang mailigtas, kung hindi upang kami ay maging mga sundalo mo at maging mananagumpay na sundalo mo sa iyong kaharian. Kaya nga dalangin ko, Panginoon, sa umagang ito, patuloy mong basbasan ang bawat isang mananampalataya. Iparealize mo sa amin, Panginoon, na kami po ay nasa isang pakikipagdigmaan na hindi kami kinakailangang maging talunan, O God. At hindi kami kinakailangang panghinaan ng loob. Dahil kilala na namin kung sino ang aming kalaban. We are not fighting against flesh and blood, but we are fighting against the rulers, against the powers, against the spiritual forces, against the spiritual powers, O God, in the spiritual wickedness, O Lord. And we pray, O Lord, patuloy mo kami bigyan ng wisdom na nanggagaling sa inyo, Panginoon, on how to fight this battle, O Lord. Kaya nga, Panginoon, hinihiling ko po, Diyos, kasihan mo kami ng iyong kapangyarihan, kasihan mo kami ng iyong Espiritu Santo. Patuloy mo kami i-equip ng iyong mga salita, Panginoon. At hinihiling ko po, Diyos, patuloy namin gamitin yung mga sandata na ibinigay mo sa amin upang kami magtagumpay, O God, upang kami hindi maging talunan, upang kami manatiling we are holding our grounds, O Lord, at maging overcomer, O God. Maging more than conquerors and victorious, Panginoon, gaya ng iyong pinangako sa iyong mga salita. Panginoon, salamat po because you are our allies. We belong to you, Lord. The battle belongs to you, Lord. We are your instruments. We are your soldiers, O God. We are your foot soldiers in this world, O Lord. But thanks be to God. You are our commander in chief, and we are in a winning side. Thank you, Father God. Kaya nga, Panginoon, sa umaga nito, patuloy niyo pong equip ang bawat isa. Patuloy niyo kaming kasihan ng inyong kapangyarihan. At patuloy niyo kaming gabayan, O Lord. Panginoon, sa pangalan ni Jesus, Dalangin ko yung mga mahal, mga kapwa ko mananampalataya na pinanghihinaan ng loob, Panginoon, palakasin mo sila ng inyong Espiritu Santo, kasihan mo sila ng inyong kapangyarihan. At ipaunawa mo sa kanila, Panginoon, na hindi kami dapat magpa-intimidate sa aming kalaban sa halip, Lord. Tinawag mo kami upang kami maging victorious, maging overcomer, maging more than conquerors, dahil yan ang iyong plano sa buhay ng bawat isa. Salamat po, O Diyos, sa umagang ito. Pinupuri ka namin, pinapasalamatan ka namin. Dinadakila namin ang inyong banal na pangalan. Panginoon, pagpalain mo po ang bawat isa, lalong-lalo na yung mga may sakit, O God, dalangin namin ang iyong kagalingan. Kaya nga sa pangalan ni Jesus, we rebuke any kind of sicknesses, any form of illnesses, any works of the enemy, in Jesus' name, over the lives of people who are praying with us. Panginoon, pagpalain nyo rin po, O God, yung mga tao na affected, greatly affected, na kung mga like your wounded soldiers, O Lord, tulungan mo po sila na makarecover, tulungan mo po sila na gumaling yung kanilang mga sugat at sila'y patuloy na lumaban muli sa pakikipagdigmaang ito. Panginoon, salamat po sa mga katotohanan ng aming pinagbulay-bulayan sa araw na ito. Kaya nga, we give you all the praise. We give you all the honor and the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Magandang umaga po, mga kapatid. At nawa'y pagpalain po kayo ng ating Panginoon Diyos at ingatan ng kanyang kapangyarihan.